My move before it's too late. The enemy set the gate. What's the tackle? Seal my fate. All my head, but they'll have to wait. Cause I'm still fighting. I'm still fighting. Hello, my name is Michelle, and welcome to Impromptu Thoughts for West Coast Mesh Fighter. California dreaming. Hello, and welcome to Impromptu Thoughts for West Coast Mesh Fighter. This is the part of the video that I have a disclosure claim. I'm not a lawyer. I'm not a doctor. I am a patient, and everything that I talk about is based on my own experiences.
This morning, a major health alert for millions of women. U.S. health regulators are halting the sale and distribution of surgical mesh used to repair pelvic conditions.
The move comes after years of reported complications from the implants. Tens of thousands of lawsuits have been filed by women who have reported injuries from the devices. This order doesn't apply to mesh products used to treat hernias or incontinence.
Opioid medication. Chronic pain. Chronic infections, pain management, stress, anxiety, uncertainty. Okay, so when I was at the county hospital and I had demanded to speak with the administration representative for the county hospital, the representative I thought was on my side regarding this. Because keep in mind, at the time I was going through this, this was not as well known then as it is now. So this is back in 2014. It's almost about 5 years ago, really. And because it had not been as publicized as it is today, they were just treating me like I was an opioid junkie, some sort of addict. Which that was far from the truth. And by doing that, they compromised my health and put me at great risk, because every time I would have a pelvic pain attack or anything to do with high levels of pain, I was forced to go to the hospital. And then they would give me a little bit of the medication, maybe like 12 pills. And then I was to suffer through it at home, and it seemed like this was like an ongoing thing. I would have a pelvic pain attack, and what that means is I would get extreme pain in the lower right abdominal area, and it would shoot down the front part of my right leg. And then after I had the Botox treatment in my pelvic region, that's when the pain in the left butt cheek shooting down the back of my left leg, and just all kinds of problems with my bowels after that. It just seemed like it was a never-ending vicious pain that I was having to live with. And some of that happened while I was with Kaiser, but most of the negative things happened when I was with the county. So while I was doing the back injection therapy, the doctor refused to, and this was one of the county doctors, refused to provide me with any pain medication because I was having this other thing done with pain management and the back injections. So it wasn't until after I had stopped that program and said, I can't do this anymore. It does a number on your mental state. It really does. And you're going through this thinking that nobody cares. Nobody cares at all. And before I even had Kaiser and I was with Blue Cross Blue Shield, I had like the best doctor, and I'd been with her for like 10 years. So I was used to that one-on-one. But then when my employer went through the insurance changes and I ended up with Kaiser, I kind of lost any kind of connection like that. And I really tried hard to work with my doctors at Kaiser, and they, for the most part, tried to do everything they could for me. So on that note, I can say, but it wasn't until I got to the county that that the real problem started. One thing that's really important that I need to make sure that I talk about is the medical insurance that I had switched to when I was with the county actually assigned me a care coordinator that helped me deal with helping manage my care somehow. This is like a new thing, and this came about because of the complaints that I had filed with the insurance regarding the lack of care that I was receiving because of the complications I was having. At least at the time, that's what was happening. And when I had dealt with my health insurance and all of that, for a time it resolved problems. I was able to get my medication without any problem, any question. It was when that care coordinator left her position after being there with me for well over a year and a new one came in that the health insurance started to pull away. And really all this revolves around pain medication, pain management, chronic infections, chronic pelvic pain, chronic colon pain, and nobody really knew what to do with it. And when the opioid price crisis really started to peak, doctors started to become afraid. Of course, I've learned this way after the fact, but at the time I didn't understand that's what was going on. And now here we are in 2019, and I finally am with a pain management doctor. I am being treated on a regular basis. My doctors are like 2 miles from each other. My primary internal medicine, along with pain management, and finally getting some pain medication. It was a very long fight, and it's still a fight, because the medical side effects that I experience along with plenty of patients that experience it. These are chronic, meaning they never stop. It never stops happening, especially those of us that still have some of it in there, so to speak. And that's my understanding from my revisional urogynecologist that performed my revisional surgery. He did advise to me that he couldn't get it all. So I know there's still some in there somewhere, because the chronic pain that I have to live with is, it's not anything that I would want to wish on somebody else. But the important part is, for a time, I had a care coordinator with my insurance. Now I manage my own care. When they started to back off and I wasn't getting anywhere and I made all the different changes, that was me taking control of my health care. This is something that's very important to do, so you can be proactive as to what the next steps could be for your healthcare.